experience. Mr. Shanta will be giving us an experience of Nepal and how they have been able to demonstrate the importance of public open space to help communities deal with the catastrophic event of the earthquakes and other disasters that strike. This presentation will highlight how the Kathmandu people particularly suffered as a result of unplanned urban development exploitation, the nature, the ways in which public space and civil society organizations supported communities in aftermath of the earthquake. So I think it's very important to hear from you, and I can see you are doing so much as an activist, and you are even awarded with WHO for contribution of tobacco control. Thank you.
First of all, let me convey best wishes to all of you from Nepal. So my presentation is basically on public spaces and especially in relation to the earthquake which we had last year. Okay. So you see, like historically, if you visit Kathmandu, the old city, we had an open space in every small settlement. Why these small open spaces are there? Because it serves different activities. Number one, in Nepal especially, when the woman will get a baby, for almost the full 1 month, every day she will be having an oil massage of her body. So this open space is also being used for oil massage, number one. Number two, for the senior citizen to interact with them and also to have some sort of religious thing, that open space is a must for all of us. And the third one is in the open space, there were lots of cultural and religious activities. And definitely, that is open space is also worked as a water aquifer so that water can be accumulated and will have a open stone tap. So if you visit Kathmandu, in different courtyards, still there is a water flowing from the stone scrub underground. Next please. So now, this is our cultural part. There is an open space for women, for swala drying of the vegetables or the grain, for senior citizens to gossip, to interact, for the other people, for religious thing and other cultural activities. But now, since we all are moving towards the urbanizations in the name of developing the city, so slowly we started exploiting the cultural part. So what we did is that the open space slowly being exploited, and then it will be replaced by concrete buildings, right? And this is how we not only expanded the cultural, the national park, we also disturb the cultural setting of the society where people would like to interact, the senior citizens will come, gossip, talk and something like that. So that all has been slowly being diminished by the so-called new urbanization of the city. Next please. Next please. So in this very scenario, last year we had an earthquake. Earthquake of 7.8 Richter scale. And fortunately, it was a daytime, and fortunately, it was a Saturday, the holiday. So that's how the casualty was a little bit less. If it would have been at the middle of the night, then really, really the casualty had been much more. But even then, more than 8,000 people died. Hundreds of thousands of people got injured, disabled. Millions of houses had been destroyed. And the destruction had been also because of the lack of space. People couldn't get a safe place during the earthquake. So they are running this way, run this way and that way, and they couldn't find it. And by the time they were running this way and that way, the house started collapsed. And they were under the rubble of the house. So this is how more casualty had been done. That's how the lack of open space made worse the earthquake in Nepal. Next one. So that's how. Now what I would like to do, that why we are advocating for the public space and open space. Number one, it contributes to the social capital. Number two, they provide a location for all members of the community to connect regardless of age, income level, and gender. Number three, so these social connections become a critical during relief work, relief efforts. Next please. So now people started realizing that public space is one of the core area, one of the very, very important area for the emergency. And because of this casualties which has to be managed, then open space is the place where you can have, you can rehabilitate the earthquake victims or even in disaster, any disaster victims. Next please. So now I would just like to have a girl. Now Nepal and German jointly, they are made a study research on open space and system index. So the study found that there was a lack of open space to be used in disasters. And that's how it is said that lack of open space has been a poor casualty. Now I think we are advocating to the municipalities, like your city corporations, that at least every 10,000 residents, there must be open space. Next please. So, that's how we do. From now onwards, all residents who must have at least 30% of a building area is open space. If you want to construct a building, within the land, at least 30% give aside for open space. So this is called, and then for the government and semi-government of the building, there must be at 50% open space. If it is. Next. So now, regarding this, what we are doing, that number one is advocacy. We would like to advocate to the government, learning from this disaster, we must have a sufficient open space. So we are in the process of having a rules and regulations being drafted, what we call it as a house construction book. This is one of the policy advocates we are doing. And then second one is, since the municipality already agreed that there should be a open space, so for each and every houses. There should be open space for each and every public buildings. So this is how we as a civil society would like to play the role of watchdog. Let this rules and regulation implement it seriously for the benefit of the people. And third one, as you as a civil society members, everybody is having a media advocacy. This is the age of media advocacy. Unless or until your work has been disseminated by the media, electronic or print media, you cannot have a public voice collectively. So, in order to pressurize the government, in order to make the people aware, you need to have a media advocacy. And definitely that let's have a small communities also working on that line. Because the ownership of any activities is very, very much necessary when you restart something. That's amazing. Next. So, whatever we do in any advocacy work, advocacy should not be in a blank seat. It should be supported by evidences. It should be supported by case studies. Right? It should be supported by data. So, the first thing we do, that we need to generate evidence on different issues, and it has to be practiced in the writing way. And the other one is, you see, voice for one organization is not sufficient. You need to have a collective. We all want to not open space, then people will listen. You know that sometimes, if really you want to pressurize the government, what we do is, we go to the street, we make a human chain, we shout the slogan, and then government will bound to listen. So, collective voice is one of the areas. That's how only one organization cannot do it. There's a coalition of other people. Like this is also the forum to advocate international on the issue. That's what we are coming here and we are advocating for this issue. That's this. So now, I'll just give finally my organization. My organization is almost more than 2 decades old. We are basically working on the health rights issue, right to health. So under right to health, we work on the different areas. Especially, we are now focusing on the livable cities and also the non-communicable diseases. So these are some of the areas which we advocate for the government and also make an awareness to the people for your collective. Next, please. So we also study in Kathmandu the marketplaces, where is the market, something like that. So these are some of the mapping of the marketplaces. Next, please. So these are some of the areas of our involvement. And once again, I would like to reiterate here that in the name of development, in the name of organization, organization, we shouldn't forget that the nature needs to nurture in a proper way so that we all will have a open space, green space to breathe, and we are very, very much close to the nature because we all are natural bodies. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Shantan. I don't know if any people have questions to ask him. Do you have questions? Okay, please come forward. Can someone help you passing the mic?
Yes, my name is George. My company is Business Innovation Research and Development. my question is about not about Kathmandu, because Kathmandu was very, very good at recovery compared to the rest of Nepal. I mean, Nepal is a landlocked country. There is a lot of mountains, and there are a lot of communities living in mountains. And as somebody told me, somebody living in Nepal told me, government never helped people in the mountains. I mean, if you go, for example, to Western Nepal, they receive no help until today. Western Nepal, for example, a community of Argon Kashir, Rimbi region, they didn't receive help. So, for example, the international community gave Nepal $4-5 billion. Can you tell me what they're doing with the money now? Thank you.
Number one, that I'm not a government person. So regarding the money, I cannot tell you. The only thing which really, really is good that the Lumbini, basically the place which you are talking, Lumbini, the Western part, where the Buddha's birthplace is that, where the all the different countries, starting from like America to Thailand, Burma to Indonesia, they're having the different places of Buddha. So they are really, really developing. And there is a 20 years development plan for the Lumbini. But as you know, that the political system is still not as conducive to Nepalese development. So the process is getting very slow. And we hope that we can make it.
Okay, we only have 2 minutes left.
Thank you very much. I'm Lekule from Tanzania. I have only one question. The open space and the buildings that are surrounding open space are equally important. How do you take them in your understanding? Because the interface is never designed, particularly in the developing countries. Thank you.
Yeah, I think you are right. Basically, we are not talking of the only the open space. We are talking of the open space with the greenery. We are talking of the making the place serene and peaceful. So that just like you can store, you can walk, you can have a fresh air to breathe on, and very much close to the nature. This is where I'm talking.
Okay, thank you for Mr. Santa Lal Mulmi. And for the next speaker and presentation is